Hello there, my gumminess, and welcome back to the Echo Chamber. Now, getting back into what if Krillin trained with King Kai after being killed by Tambourine? So we last left off with the Z-Fighters going on the search for the androids. They ended up finding them and engaging with them in battle, but it ended up being pretty much a slaughter, with Vegeta taking the cake and otherwise manhandling Android 19. Dr. Roh ended up going and running away, and Trunks ended up returning, confirming to the group the idea that these were not the androids that they were indeed looking for, or at least the androids from his time. They would end up following Dr. Roh, tracking him down back towards his lab, where he would indeed unleash the other androids, but unfortunately for him, he was ended up killed by them. And whereas things didn't remain the same as they did in canon, the three androids were indeed still released, and there ended up a few differences, like given the fact that Goku never caught the heart virus, given the fact that he was indeed taking his medicine, thus preventing him from getting it, so he was actually there during the battle, with Android 16 taking the fight to him, with the other two androids taking the fight to the rest of the group. They were easily able to overcome them, especially given that most of the group had ended up being caught off guard, with Goku himself only putting up a mild resistance against Android 16, before the other androids came in with an assist in order to be able to take him down, leading to all three of them standing over the top of him, prepared to finish him off. And we'll be picking up with this part right now.
Last night took a L, but tonight I bounce back. Wake up every morning, by the night I count stacks. Knew that ass was real when I hit it, bounce back.
The three androids stand atop Goku's unconscious body, with 16 beginning to prepare a Hell's Flash in order to finish off Goku once and for all, with 17 getting ready to step in front in order to be able to make a protest, given the fact that he was dissatisfied with how easy this all ended up being. He expected from the data that they gathered that Goku would have put up much more of a fight, and that he wouldn't have been taken down so easily. 18 basically confronts him and tells him just to back off and let 16 do his thing. That was a part of his whole program or whatever, just to go on and kill Goku, whereas they were kinda like mostly in it for the fun, and that it really didn't matter in the end which one of them ended up killing him. In fact, she was far more interested in doing something else, like going shopping for instance, which 17 found entirely boring. 16, on the other hand, was laser focused, as his target was right there. Summoning up the energy necessary in order to be able to wipe Goku off the face of the planet, he was prepared to fire. But right in that moment, before he was able to do anything, he was kicked in the face and sent flying by an enraged Super Saiyan Gohan, who along with Yajirobe had teleported back in the nick of time. With both 17 and 18 also caught off guard, Yajirobe was actually about to come down with a swing of his sword in a Kaioken times 20 against Android 18, looking to decapitate her immediately. But she managed to notice at the last second, regaining her composure, and lifted her arm in response, which completely shattered Yajirobe's sword on it. 18 then aimed a punch toward Yajirobe's face, which would have connected if not for Krillin using instant transmission, getting right in front of her, and using a solar flare, which completely blinded 18, allowing him to burst into a Kaioken times 40, where he kicked her in the face, knocking her away, before telling Yajirobe to go and handle the others while he went off to go and fight Android 17, who had also been caught into the solar flare, thus giving Krillin somewhat of an advantage as he rushed towards him, starting to fight him off. Yajirobe, doing as Krillin asked, immediately grabbed Goku in order to be able to take him off somewhere safe so he can give him a Senzu Bean, as well as give the others. Gohan, on the other hand, was going after 16 after knocking him away. He was still enraged and thus not really focused on anything else but his target. And once he caught up to 16, who by this point was still flying through the air, trying his best to stop himself, Gohan landed another combination attack on him, punches and kicks galore before blasting him down with a Kamehameha wave straight in towards the ground. 16, however, was eventually able to stop himself, and once gaining his footing, was able to deflect a Kamehameha wave, him charging at Gohan in return, and the two begin to clash with each other. Now, I do want to go ahead and take the time to express to the idea that the only reason why Gohan's even putting up this much of a fight is due to his rage boost. Given the fact that he saw that Goku was basically on the verge of near death, and how injured he was, it allowed him to access a state. Yes, he does indeed have Super Saiyan, but let's be honest, it would still be nowhere near the level it needs to be in order to be able to go up against 16, despite the fact that he has been training with it much longer than he was in canon. But if I had to give a rough estimate, I would say that this rage boost would put him very closely near the same level as an ascended Vegeta, but still quite a few notches below, but just getting up towards near that level. Thus, I would say he boasts the raw power advantage over 16, however, it's not a very high margin. And given the fact that we've seen 16's analytical mind, and the fact of the way he's able to calculate fights, energy, and data, he'd be able to predict a lot more of Gohan's movements, and therefore the fight is much more even between the two, despite the fact that Gohan has a marginal power difference. Nevertheless, two continue to battle going back and forth, and whereas Gohan does indeed boast a small power advantage over 16 in terms of his raw strength, he doesn't really have the attack nor fight sense in order to honestly take an advantage over him, and thus he is simply wearing himself out, in the same vein that Vegeta did when he first fought 18 in canon, whereas it necessarily wasn't the idea that only 18 was stronger than Vegeta, but the fact that androids have infinite energy and therefore can keep fighting continuously, and that because Vegeta had gotten the Super Saiyan recently, he wasn't able to put up much of a fight due to the fact that he was consistently exhausting himself and had to train with the form in order to be able to hone its energy more. Whereas it's not the exact same scenario, the same situation could be said for Gohan in this case, due to the fact that his rage is causing him to throw out more power with less precision. And therefore, although they were even at first, after a while, 16 begins to take the upper hand as Gohan begins to get more tired and powering down, allowing 16 to finally break through his guard and give him a solid hit, at which point he begins to pound on him, knocking him back and forth over and over again. Meanwhile, back at the fight with both Krillin and 17, the difference is much more noticeable, given the fact that 17 is much stronger and faster than Krillin. However, it's Krillin's tenacity and battle experience that is basically keeping him ahead, as he's trying to employ the strategy of essentially using some reverse psychology on 17, trying to get in the 10 and throw him off his game, given the fact that he recognizes that 17 can't actually fight all that well, at least in comparison to him. It's not that 17 isn't a natural prodigy or gifted fighter, especially given the fact that he's an android. He's already showed high level skill, even within canon, going up against what would be more experienced fighters like Piccolo. But in this case, Krillin's vastly more array of fundamental understandings within martial arts and his teachers has prepared him for situations like this. 17 is able to overcome the mind games at first, but Krillin keeps digging deeper and basically showcasing a level of battle mind that 17 just wasn't simply prepared for, which gave Krillin several openings, allowing him to basically hit 17 on several occasions with his attacks. And whereas at first these attacks were doing absolutely nothing, 17 basically tanking them all, it was all a part of Krillin's strategy, as he was imploring the Four Spirit Fission technique in order to be able to separate the energies from 17's body in order to be able to severely weaken him. So with Krillin fighting those openings, he begins to draw the energy out, and this does have the added effect of indeed weakening 17, allowing Krillin's hits to take more of effect. However, it's only really a temporary solution. As Krillin begins to realize, the fact is he can only keep up with 17 at this stage of Kaioken, but using this stage of Kaioken is going to be extremely taxing on him eventually. So whereas he is able to somewhat bring 17 down to his level, it's really more just like a mind game that he's playing with him, trying his best to at least keep 17 on his toes until the other fighters can get in to offer some assists. But however, 17 does regain his composure and begins to overpower Krillin once again, basically informing him that he's not like the energy model that he fought before. He's built in with both infinite energy and stamina, recognizing that Krillin must have been using some type of technique in order to be able to take that away from him, but he said that it wouldn't work, as he would just be able to replenish any energy that was lost. Krillin, now recognizing that he was at a disadvantage, began to play more into his roots, and therefore he combined the actor image with the Kienzan, which ended up actually working, as 17 was indeed caught off guard by the sudden maneuver, and was actually about to get hit with a Kienzan straight to the back of the neck. But right before Krillin was able to launch it, he was suddenly stopped by a kick that came straight into the side of his face, knocking him away, slamming him through a few trees in the process. The kick had come from none other than 18, who had rejoined the Fae at the side of 17 in order to be able to battle Krillin together, stating to him that she hoped he wasn't having too much fun without her. 17 just smiled, welcoming her back, promoting the idea that they end this little dwarf once and for all, with 18 actually commenting back that he didn't have to be so rude. In fact, she thought Krillin was actually kind of cute. 17 just rolled his eyes at this and told her to come on as they blasted off towards Krillin. Krillin himself had just recovered after being kicked so hard, staggering back to his feet and wiping the blood from his mouth.
Damn, I won't win like this.
He noted that to himself, trying to think of a strategy that he can use in order to be able to gain the upper hand. He could try Four Spirit Fission again, except this time direct the energy towards him in order to bolster his own power. But he recognized that even that was fruitless, as whereas the endeavor, just like his first time trying to catch 17 off guard with Four Spirit Fission, may indeed work at the beginning, it won't be a long-lasting solution in order to be able to do anything significant in regards to damage against them. But it was now or never. He knew he had to do something, as the androids approached him, stopping right before him. 17 ended up speaking up, pointing out to Krillin that he actually was one hell of a fighter, and that he did an amazing job. But this is where it ends, 18 noting that it was such a shame, especially given her mild attraction towards him. She really didn't want to end up killing him, but in this case, it would look like she had no choice. Krillin took his fighting stance, not wanting to back down, thinking to himself that at this point, he would just be buying time. The androids then started performing one of their most infamous tactics, that being what I like to call the twin magic, as well as the same fear tactics that they use against both Gohan, or future Gohan in this case, and also future Trunks. Seemingly enough, blending into each other as they blitz towards Krillin. Him recognizing that he had no choice, he ended up pushing his Kaioken to his maximum limit, which in this case was a Kaioken times 50, thus granting him a power boost that was somewhat equivalent to the Super Saiyan boost that somebody like Goku or Gohan or Vegeta or Trunks would get. And whereas this did help Krillin fend off their initial barrage, it was quickly becoming apparent that this was a terrible move on his part, given that really this was a last resort, as the strain and the stamina loss in regards to what Krillin would be experiencing was still far too great for his body to be able to handle, even with the regulation training from the spirit control. And after a while, he ends up running out of gas, this being notable when the fact that 17 and 18 were both now getting extremely clean hits on him, Krillin unable to do anything but just sit around and be toyed with, and whereas he does try to defend himself, his attacks are sloppy and too slow and not powerful enough to do any significant damage, him constantly missing or even when he does land, it quickly being blocked and guarded, and Krillin just takes another hit, with the androids at one point even treating him like a pinball, and how even 18 got in a quick kiss on his cheek, which Krillin did try to retaliate with a backhand, but that was swiftly dodged as well, which made it all too clear to Krillin that he was absolutely screwed. The androids ended up finishing him off by knocking him towards the ground with swift kicks as they both landed into his chest. They were about to give Krillin the future Gohan treatment, but a blast came rocketing out of nowhere, slamming right into 17, though he managed to block it at the last second, wondering who the hell had just shot him with that. The blast having come from none other than Vegeta, who stood there in all his glory proud of himself, a malicious smile etched across his face, as he said to both 17 and 18,
"Alright, you chewed up washing machines, your fight is with me now. No more picking on the weak."
Before turning into a Super Saiyan and blitzing over towards 17, using the same tactic that he would later on use against Pui Pui, that ended up knocking 17 away, as Vegeta gave chase. 18 was getting ready to join in and trying to help her brother, but then something caught her attention. Her looking back, she sees all the rest of the Z fighters, Yamcha, Tien, Piccolo, Krillin, Yajirobe, all coming racing towards her, she having no choice but to confront them. Meanwhile, back with Gohan at 16, it became quite clear that Gohan was put on the back foot, as he was bleeding profusely and huffing and puffing, almost keeled over. He wiped the blood from his face, getting back into his battle stance, recognizing to himself that no matter what, he couldn't give up here, noting that his father would never give up if he was in this situation, and so therefore, Gohan would continue into the bitter end. 16 was menacingly walking towards him, and once he got within a few feet's distance, he ended up raising his fist, with the intent of firing a rocket punch in order to finish off Gohan. He did so, but right before it could make contact out of nowhere, the fist was kicked away, sent flying, it almost slamming back into 16, but he managed to catch it, reattaching it to his arm. The kick had come from none other than Goku, who was standing before Gohan, telling him to rest easy, and that he was proud of him, saying that he would take it from here. Gohan smiled weakly up at his father, before powering down and passing out. Goku caught him before he hit the ground though, and teleported him away quickly, to get him out of the range of the battle, coming back almost immediately and confronting 16. Going full-powered Super Saiyan. Now keep in mind when I say this, I do not mean that Goku has unlocked Grade 4. I'm just saying that Goku has gone at his current maximum level that he can achieve when turning Super Saiyan, which in this case is actually just as strong as an enraged Gohan, meaning that he's actually only a couple of notches from being around the Ascended Saiyan level, which still puts him above 16, even if ever so slightly. And the reason why I'm only saying slightly is because you gotta keep in mind that 16 was comparable and dead even with the human absorbed. The number is kinda like unquantifiable, but most people try to say like 100. But anyway, a human absorbed cell, which was significantly stronger than both 17 and 18, and on par with 16, who we do know, just like in canon, would still be stronger than both 17 and 18. It's just my way of saying that I believe that 16 and that human absorbed cell are pretty much around a 2x decrease from an ascended Super Saiyan. I would actually even argue maybe even like a 3x decrease, but nonetheless, I'm basically saying that Goku is indeed above both that Cell and 16. However, he has not reached the level of Grade 4, nor has he reached the level of an Ascended Saiyan, but he is pretty much close. On top of that, he's also receiving a bit of a rage jam, especially given the condition that he just saw Gohan in. Nevertheless, the two stare down at each other, but Goku is the first one to strike, shouting out to 16 to help pay for what he had done, before charging over to 16 was actually taken aback as Goku had managed to actually blitz him, throwing a swift kick straight towards his face, knocking 16 for a loop as he was sent flying. But Goku didn't let up the barrage. He began slamming him over and over straight into the ground as he was pounding him down, a multiple combination assault with a fury of punches and kicks, leaving 16 really no way to counter. As whereas Goku was at the same level that Gohan was, the difference between them was that Goku had none of the drawbacks that came with it. He was angry, yes, but his anger was more controlled than it was for Gohan, and he wasn't losing sight of his prowess or skills, especially when it comes to his martial arts abilities. So basically, he gets all the benefits of being at a state like this without any of the drawbacks, meaning that right now, he is legitimately overpowering 16. But whereas things are going well for Goku back with the others, it's not looking too hot. As the group that went after 18, despite the fact that they were ganging up on her and they had things like Kaioken helping back them up and everyone being significantly stronger than they were in canon, it still was virtually no match for 18, who was essentially handling them. The only problem with her in regards to taking them down immediately was the fact that they worked so well together, but their teamwork was only helping them out so much. They were still for the most part getting kicked around like it was nobody's business. And in regards to Vegeta and 17, whereas Vegeta did have the upper hand at the beginning, 17 quickly began to overpower him. This is due to the fact that whereas Vegeta is stronger than he was in canon, and most likely would have put up a much better fight had he had been fighting against Android 18, 17 we know is stronger than 18. So even though Vegeta has gotten much stronger than he was in canon and would have done better against her, he's only doing marginally decent against 17, and even then, it's still not enough to overpower him, and in fact, 17 has begun to gain the upper hand. Krillin, who was now resting alongside Gohan, wanted to go in there and help, thinking that his friends were going to end up getting killed, but at the same time, he was wondering what could he possibly do, especially given his performance. Even if he was healed by a Senzu Bean, it wouldn't really matter. Would he even make that much of a difference in regards to the fight? Sure, maybe. But at this point, all he was thinking was the best thing for them to do was just run away, which caused him to slam his fist into the ground, saying that he shouldn't be thinking like that, that it made him feel like a coward. But Krillin's train of thought was broken out of this upon feeling the surge in Goku's power, recognizing just how massive it was, noting that he had never felt power like this come from Goku, that he was way stronger than what he thought. Krillin was of course right in his assessment, as back at the battle with 16 and Goku, where 16 did manage to regain his footing and was actually doing some damage towards Goku, as he had managed to land a few clean hits, as well as knock him off course with a few ki blasts. However, the battle was still majoritarily in Goku's favor. This forced 16 into a no-win scenario. Recognizing that he still had a bomb in his chest, he was going to end up using it, so rocketing off towards the sky, Goku gave chase, which was a part of 16's plan, as he was going to let Goku hit him, that way he could grab onto Goku. And keep in mind, 16 was able to hold Perfect Cell. I know some people are going to say, well, that's plot and do stupidity, but since Goku is nowhere near that level yet, then it perfectly stands to reason that most likely 16 would be able to hold him, even though, yes, at this point, Goku, as I've stated, is stronger. Like I said, if he could hold Perfect Cell to get ready to do the bomb technique, then he can most likely hold Goku. Whether or not you consider that plot and do stupidity is kind of irrelevant to that. So yes, that was his plan, to grab onto Goku and blow himself up. Goku almost didn't catch on in time, but lucky for him, he began to feel the swelling mass of energy that was beginning to come from the bomb that 16 was starting to charge up in order to be able to use against him, with Goku himself more or less figuring out what his plan was. But Goku basically recognized that he wouldn't be able to escape it, given the fact that he was far too close in order to be able to suddenly stop and pull back, meaning that if he kept on the same trajectory, 16 would end up succeeding and grabbing onto him. So instead of trying to stop or pull back, he ends up pushing forward. increasing both his speed and power by way of the Ozaru Fist, which allowed him to not only catch right up to 16, but this was before he can gather enough energy and was unable to grasp him as Goku punched right through his arm, as 16 did indeed try to clamp down on him, sending his right arm flying off his body. This catches everyone else's attention on the battlefield, specifically 17 and 18, who was prepared to finish off the rest of the group, having finally overcome them within their own battles. Looking towards the direction where the attack came from, they see what ended up happening to 16. They couldn't believe what Goku had been able to do, both of them recognizing that if he was able to do that to 16, it wouldn't be too far off to recognize the idea that if Goku had ended up joining the other Z Fighters, that it could be trouble for them. Keeping in mind that you, the audience, would definitely know that, in fact, 16 is stronger than both of them, so therefore, if Goku could do that to 16, he most likely would just instantly be able to kill both of them and end them. But they don't know that, given that even in canon, 17 thought he was the strongest among the androids, and had no idea how powerful 16 really was until the actual fight with Cell. Nevertheless, they don't want to lose a big gun like that, so regrouping, they end up blasting down towards the rest of the Z Fighters, not with the attempt to kill, but essentially with the attempt to disorient, and knock them out or knock them unconscious in order to stop them from getting in the way as they were going to go after Goku, with the hopes of rescuing 16, let alone if he were to regroup with the other Z Fighters. Both of them rocketing towards Goku, sending out a volley of Ki Blasts, which, given the fact that Goku was off guard, he ended up taking some to the back, as he didn't know that the attack was coming, until he finally turned around, at the last second managing to put up an energy shield, which for the most part was blocking off a lot of the Ki Blasts, but that wasn't a part of the android's plan, as when the smoke cleared, they were gone, having managed to get close enough to 16 during that assault and grab him away. Goku breathed a heavy sigh, looking around to see if there was any trace of them, but once he couldn't pick up one, he powered back down. He then flew off to go and attend to the others.
And that is where I'll be leaving you guys. So, remember to do all those YouTube things, like, subscribe, share this video around to everyone you know, and the next part is going to be coming out soon, hopefully within the following week after this video goes live. Anyway, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.
And to all my Gummy Knights, new and old, just remember, this is a man's world, but it would be nothing without his brain and his bronze. And lying is indeed the most fun that a woman can have without taking off her clothes. Good night.